jurusan Bahasa Inggris di Universitas Negeri Malang. Pada hari ini, Selasa tanggal 13 Juli 2023, saya akan melaksanakan praktek pembelajaran dalam rangka penilaian uji kinerja dengan model pembelajaran problem based learning. Untuk materi yang akan saya berikan adalah narrative text dan saya akan belajar di unit kerja saya yaitu SMK Negeri 1 Sampang, Kabupaten Sampang, Provinsi Jawa Timur. Selamat menyaksikan.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning everyone.
Good morning, sir.
How are you today?
Fine.
I'm fine too, thank you. Today, I would like to say that I'm really glad to meet you because this morning is going to be the last meeting for us because the next meeting you are going to face the final exam. Yeah, so you have to prepare well. All right, before we start the lesson, please the leader lead us to pray.
Before start the lesson, let's pray together. Pray begin. Finish.
Amin, thank you. To make sure all of you are coming in my class, I would like to read the attendee list first. The first one is Icha and Mukit, and then Arjunaidi. Before we start our lesson again, please stand up, all of you. Yeah, stand up, please. Purpose of this icebreaking to motivate you in learning. This icebreaking is quite easy. You have to just clap and click your finger. Okay. This is BIM. BAM. PD. Okay. BIM. BAM. PD. And the song is must be bim bam bim bam PD PD bam PD bam PD PD bam bim bam bim bam bim bam PD PD bam PD bam PD PD bam bim bam bim bam bim bam Pidi pidi bam, pidi bam, pidi pidi bam, bim bam, bim bam, pidi pidi bam, pidi bam, pidi pidi bam, bim bam, bim bam, pidi pidi bam, pidi bam, pidi pidi bam, bim bam. I just want to check you about what we learned last week. Yeah, we learned something that really essential for you for telling about your experience. And then, what kind of materials that we learned last week? Anyone? Yeah, Ica, please.
We learn about recount text, sir.
Recount text, okay. Recount text. The main function of recount text, yeah.
To retell about the past events here.
To retell about your
past events,
okay. Do you know these following tales? Do you know this following tale? What kind of the tale is it?
Cinderella.
Cinderella. Okay, Cinderella. How do you know this Cinderella? Kenapa ini Cinderella? Bisa dilihat dari apanya? Iya, the shoes ya. The shoes ya.
Maling Kundang
ya. How you determine this is the story is about Maling Kundang? Ada mother and Maling Kundang ya. In this moment, in a narrative text, I would like to tell you, I would like to discuss with you about some parts. The first one, you are going to learn about listening a story entitled Stone Soup. From this story, you will are able to find some difficult words from listening. Yeah. And the second one is, you are able to identify the main function of narrative text itself. And the third one, you are able to identify the generic structure of the text, the narrative text itself. And the third one, you are able to identify the direct and indirect speech from the text that you were to obtain after you learn together with me. We are going to learn about a special tale. Yeah. Have you ever heard about this? The story, the end title is The Stone Soup. Pernah dengar nggak sih? Pernah? Anyone? Pernah? No, okay, that's why we are going to learn a lot about this story. And while you are listening this story, yeah, I'm going to play this video. And then you have to fill the blank right here. I'm going to give you some exercise to train your ability in listening, and then you have to pay attention on the video. While you are listening, you write down some blank words that provided in this worksheet. Okay?
Stone soup. Once upon a time, a boy old soldier was coming home from the war. The poor soul wandered from one village to another, threadbare and hungry. He was offered no bread or even a little hot soup anywhere at all. He went from house to house asking for something to eat. But the people either set the dogs on him or told him they themselves were too poor to eat. As he carried on from gate to gate, he made up his mind to go into the first house and make a pot of soup for himself, whoever the owner of the house might be. He picked up a stone at the entrance of the house and walked in. The owner was an old woman. "Good morning, old lady." "Good morning to you, young soldier. Are you well today, old lady?" "I am well. And how are you, young soldier?" "I'm also well. But I have to say that I would love to eat a little soup, if you have any to spare." "Oh, young soldier, I'm glad you'd give me some if I had any. But I'm too old."
To make sure you have already listening carefully about the Hungarian folk tales entitled Stone Soup, I just want to make sure about your comprehension in listening based on the close test that I give to you. Okay, for the number one, what are the blank word for number one?
Coming.
Okay. Number two.
Wondered.
Yeah? Was it?
Wondered.
Wondered. Okay, wondered. And number three.
When.
Okay. Number four.
Call.
All right. And then number five.
Carrot.
Yeah, carrot. And number six.
Meat.
Yeah, as I told you before, we are going to learn about narratives, and then I'm going to explain a little bit about narrative itself. Jadi, when you learn about narrative, apa sih yang you obtain after you read the story? Setelah baca ceritanya, what do you feel? Apa? Yeah, you feel happy, yeah. After you learn about the narrative, you feel happy. Means that the main function of the narrative itself is to make the reader happy, to entertain, or to amuse the reader. Jadi untuk menghibur atau membuat para pembacanya gembira. The next part. We have some general structure of the narrative text. The first one is orientation. Kalau orientation buat apa ya? Awalan cerita. The orientation biasanya mengenalkan apa?
Tokoh.
Yeah, the characters, yeah. And then the settings of the place and time. And then for the next one is complication. Complication means the problem arises. Masalah mulai
datang.
Muncul satu persatu. And the next one is resolution. The problem is
penyelesaian.
Yeah, solve. Selesai masalahnya, begitu kan? Today I want to make sure that you are able to identify the general structure of the text, this text, namely narrative. That's why I'm going to make you some groups.
Yeah,
I'm going to make you some groups. And each group consists of 5 students. And you have already make a group in the previous meeting, right?
Yeah.
From now on, please sit with your group. If I'm not mistaken, the first one is Firman. Second one is
Icha.
The third one is
Tias.
The fourth one is Nasril. Please work together with your friend right now. Yeah, silakan.
Yes.
Move. I'm going to give you 2 parts of piece of worksheet. All you have to do, you read this text first carefully with your friends, and then you are welcome. And as I told you before, After you receiving this worksheet, all you have to do is you have to identify the generic structure of the text. Ya, generic structure-nya of the text. Jadi, dari cerita Grasshopper and Toad, you have to determine struktur teksnya. Dimulai dari orientation, tentang apa yang ada di cerita itu. And the second one is about complication-nya, apa masalah yang mulai timbul based on the story. And the last one, resolution-nya. The solution from this story. Bagaimana cerita itu berakhir. Gitu ya. After you have already identified the general structure of the text, you have to present right here. Yeah, one by one. Okay? Start from now, please. Okay, you may use your mobile phone, yeah, to support your ability in determine about the general structure of the text.
Yeah.
Sudah ada kan ya? Okay. I'll give you 5 minutes to finish up this work. So please work collaboratively with your friend to solve your problem. It's time for you to present your work right now. Yeah, to present your work right now. Please, all the leaders coming up in front of the class to determine about your who will present the materials, what is it? The analyzing of the generic structure narrative text. I'm going to ask randomly by playing a game. The instruction is really easy. The instruction is really easy. All of you is just have you know about kepala, pundak, lutut, kaki? Ya, taruh dulu itunya. Ya. But in English, okay? Head, shoulder, knees and toes. Knees and toes together. One more together. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes, okay? Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes, okay. I'm going to give instruction right now. 1, 2, 3, go! Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. Head, 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 head. Pencil! Yeah! Okay, berarti yang will present the material is yang present the material Icha, but the student that not able to get the pen is Tias and Firman. Okay, have a seat please, two of you. Sorry. Start again.
The analysis of the generic structure of the text entitled Toad and Grasshopper as follows. First, orientation. It describes about the character in the story, namely Toad and Grasshopper. The story happened in the wood and it happened a long time ago. Second, complication. The problem begins to arise when the toad invites the grasshopper to dine with him and his wife. When the grasshopper tried to eat, he made a loud noise and made the toad mad. He asked the grasshopper to stop chirping while eating. And of course, he couldn't do that because he would like to give a lesson to the toad. He asked toad and have dinner with him in the next day. Third resolution, the toad got angry because grasshopper complimented him all the time because of all his hopping. The toad made some dirt on his paws. After cleaning his paws, it could make the food dirty. After this dying, they had no longer in friendship.
Okay, thank you. Give big applause for her. The next one.
To present the analysis of the gendering structure of the next excited toad and grasshopper. First orientation is described about each character in the story, such as toad and grasshopper. The story happened in the dense forest and the setting of the time it called be happened at noon. Complication. Problem of the story was the toad always complained the grasshopper because of the chirping all the time while eating the food. Then the grasshopper wanted to take a revenge of the toad by asking him to dine with grasshopper. Resolution. The toad got angry because the grasshopper complained him all the time because of all his hopping. The toad made some dirt on his paw after cleaning his paws and ate it cold, make the food dirty. After this time, the head not longer frenzy.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Have a seat, please. From now on, I would like to show you about the direct and indirect speech. So, pay attention on my explanation, and then I'm going to ask you one by one related to the direct and indirect speech. Yeah? Yeah, you good? Direct speech are quotes, the exact words spoken. Direct speech in writing have also marks, yeah? Ada tanda petiknya, begitu. Meanwhile, for indirect speech, itu to talk about past. Jadi, seseorang yang membicarakan sesuatu dilaporkan kepada orang lain. Itu we call indirect speech. And list, we have to determine how to determine about the direct and indirect speech. We have to know about the tenses. Yeah? The first one. Kalau contohnya direct speech. He said, I live in the city center. Tensesnya kira-kira apa? Present simple. Kalau indirect speech-nya jadi apa? Arjun, indirect speech-nya dari present simple jadi past tense. Kemudian, he said, I'm going out. Present continuous. Itu berubah menjadi? Ya? Can we repeat one more time?
Past continuous tense.
Kalau present perfect, itu berubah menjadi?
Past perfect.
Nah, dari teks yang kalian miliki tentang narrative text entitled Grasshopper and Toad, kalian, you have to determine, yeah, determine about some sentences that containing about direct speech, and then you have to change into indirect speech. But before that, I'm going to call the leader again. Come here. The leader, come here. Yeah.
Go
Yang menghalangi kamera di sini. Oke, di sini. Nah, dari teks yang udah saya beri, I've give already give distributed some text to you. What you have to do if you have to find out the direct speech, yeah, di teks ini, and then you change into indirect speech. Ya. Yeah. Kemudian setelah kamu tulis, ya, kamu buat di selembar beberapa kertas, begitu, ya. Jadi satu direct speech, ada indirect speech, kamu buat dari kertas kecil, ditulis di situ. Setelah selesai, dibuat bola-bola, begitu ya. Silakan kembali ke tempat duduknya. Jangan lupa per lembar kertas kecil. Oke. Sudah dapat? Ya. Direct speech-nya setelah itu ini ya. Dibuat bulat-bulatan nanti ya. Ya, sudah dapat?
Sudah.
Ya. Pastikan direct speech-nya ya, direct speech-nya yang mana begitu ya.
Ya.
Nanti dibuat bola-bola setelah itu. After you did your work, you make some balls from the question that you have already written on the worksheet. Yeah, make some balls, everyone. Make some balls. Yeah, make some balls. After that, I'll give you instruction. When I count, ketika aku count 1, 2, 3, you throw to your friend. 3, 2, go. Okay. You got it. You got it? Okay, just call it right now. Start from group you, Icha. Read the direct speech and you have to change into indirect speech. Louder. Keras suaranya.
Direct speech. You just don't want me to eat with you.
You just don't want me to eat with you. How you change into indirect speech?
Indirect speech, the toad cried that the grasshopper just didn't want him to eat with grasshopper.
Okay, is it correct? Benar?
Yes.
Yes, okay, good.
Direct speech, he said to toad, invite you to me house for dinner tomorrow.
Okay, how to change into indirect speech?
Indirect speech, the grasshopper said to the toad that to invite to the toad to this house for dinner the following day.
Okay, good. As I told you before, I'm going to give you an evaluation. Please check in your mobile phone. Yeah, especially in Google Classroom, you check first. Now. Yeah, please do the evaluation number 1 up to number 10. Yeah, number 1 up to number 10, and then you have to submit me directly. Ya, submit me directly, segera dikumpulkan. Oke? Okay? Ya. Yeah. Start from now, silakan. Oke, okay, class. We have already learned something that really new for you about narrative text. Yeah? And narrative text is has some special function for you. Can you tell me, after we learn about narrative text, what we can obtain about the function of narrative text? Anyone? The function of narrative text. Sylvie? Yeah? Tell me the function of narrative text.
Narrative text is used to entertain the readers.
Yeah, it's used to entertain the readers.
There are some type of narrative text, such as legend, fairy tale, and fable.
Okay, ada legend, fairy tale, and fable. Thank you so much. And the next one. Is there anyone can recall about the generic structure of the text? Yeah, okay.
Orientation, complication, and resolution.
Okay, orientation, complication, and resolution. Thank you both of you. Give big applause. Yeah. I do believe that you have already got something new in this exercises and also the materials related to the narrative text. Are you happy for today?
Happy!
Okay, give big applause for us. That's all for today. Thank you for your attention, and don't forget, for the next meeting, you have to bring your LKPD to learn together about narrative text. Yeah, that's all. Thank you so much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.